part of the Moors in contemporary design. I dreamed in color, I thought in color, I told in color. Just remembering my trip to Portugal, the colorful tiles pop into my mind as fast as the delicious food, the endless white beaches, and, of course, surfing in Portugal. Some people say that one of the most captivating works of art in Portugal is on the street, hand-painted tiles, Azulejo. Lozenge, I start from the very beginning to tell a little story and, in fact, what impressed me the most. The transmission of this art, and how figuratively and interestingly some small tiles tell stories. You walk the streets and listen to tales from the centuries. They were like the tales of Moroccan storytellers in Jamar El Fna Square, the center of the Medina in Marrakesh, which is always full of people. There are also storytellers among the goods on the market stalls, with cobra and monkey trainers, jugglers, rope players, and dancers. They are paid modestly, but this is not the most important thing for them. In Morocco, they are highly respected. They are constantly surrounded by people who watch and listen to them as if they are enchanted. Storytellers practice the ancient art of Hikayat, the ability to tell a fascinating and sweet-spoken story. Hiccups have existed for more than 1,000 years. Some of the stories are recorded, others are heard only by the narrators. Berber and Arabic tales are told. Traditionally, the narrators are men. The art of storytelling was once widespread in all parts of Morocco. Today, Jamaica's El Fna Square in Marrakesh is one of the last places we can enjoy it, and storytellers are disappearing. Lozenge, I imagined that the Azulejo tiles tell exactly these stories. This Moorish heritage has been adopted by the Portuguese and has been used surprisingly over the centuries. Exquisite tile panels cover all walls, from the train station to buildings or churches, with stories painted on ceramic surfaces. The word Azulejo comes from the Arabian word Azuli or Al-Zulisha, which means small polished stone, and is a ceramic piece, usually square, with a glass polished front. Azulejo is the art that gives Portugal its identity. In fact, the tiles initially originated in Egypt, first brought to Portugal by the Arabs in the 13th century during their invasion, which also helped shape Portuguese culture. During the reign of King D. Manuel I, the tiles were first introduced in Portugal. He is said to have been blinded by the Alhambra Palace, Granada, and decided to decorate his palace in Sintra in the same way. In the 16th century, Islamic motifs were gradually replaced by European motifs with Gothic and Renaissance references. However, the use of Spanish Moorish techniques withstood the new influences. The Portuguese accepted painting on ceramic tiles as their national art. Many artists preferred tiles to canvas, painting religious images and historical scenes and bright decorative details. Inspired by many cultures, including Asian, Arabic, Italian, Flemish, Spanish, and Dutch, the styles range from Baroque to Art Nouveau to contemporary. They range from simple, repetitive patterns to massively complex and sophisticated murals. Gradually, Portuguese artists abandoned only decorative elements and began to use designs of people or animals. They decorate everything, from the walls of churches and monasteries to palaces, ordinary houses, and often depict scenes from the country's history. Earlier it was a sign of wealth, the more beautiful the tiles, the richer the owner. Portuguese tiles come in many shapes and are made of ceramic and are painted and polished to withstand time and wear. They were not only decorative but also functional, they protected from moisture, heat, and noise. The Alfama district of Lisbon, where I was amazed by the diversity of this beautiful Portuguese heritage, all around us, involving us in new and new curious stories. Each new piece completed my own Portuguese puzzle. I was wondering where the blue came from. In Portugal, most of the tiles I saw mainly were white and blue. These predominant colors were considered very modern during discoveries, from the 15th to the 18th century. They are also associated with porcelain from Oriente and have a Dutch influence, the so-called Delft blue from Delft, the calm blue heart of the Orange Kingdom. The color blue was perceived as a synonym for power and wealth, so I quickly recognized it on important monuments throughout the country. The first tile factory dated back to the 18th century and was built in Lisbon, the capital of Portugal. Lozenge, I was fascinated by the National Tile Museum in Lisbon and how vital and fundamental Portuguese culture is. It was worth the long trip to see the 16th century building, the Madre de Deus, which is deceptively modest on the outside and an incredible example of Baroque architecture and decoration on the inside. Famous paintings, lavishly gilded altars, and any other surfaces that once looked ordinary, relics of convents and, of course, azulejos, all competed for my attention. Lozenge, I was impressed that people who build their facades with Portuguese tiles are always trying to connect them with the building's history to this day. Initially, Portuguese tiles were bought only by wealthy families, so they were not used so much abroad. Over time, the trend changes, and they begin to be used to construct any building, so nowadays, it is possible to see them almost everywhere. Tiles are also widely used in interior design as accents. Most people decorate and decorate their houses with these small geometric shapes. In addition, many hotels and public buildings greet their customers with beautiful azulejo tile panels in their lobbies. Detailed frescoes depicting churches and monasteries are very common. This type of painting is very typical of the church, as it depicts biblical passages and illustrates them in as much detail as possible. Only rich people had access to the Bible, so painting tiles was how the church associated with the masses. I wanted to buy souvenir tiles, make a poster, and tell a little story about my experiences in Portugal. Not only were the tiles colored, but their prices were colored. When you are in Lisbon, you can find tiles to buy, Santa Rufina, Cortico and Netos. If you are in Porto, there are Prometeu Artesanato, Zinda Atelier or Bramica. Lozenge, I tried to tell my story from my experience in Portugal. Each new piece completed my own Portuguese puzzle. With the help of Azulejo, try to tell your story. What will it be like? Links are in the description box www.alluringlifeweb.com.